Dear students, I, Mr. Vishal Shah, Assistant Professor, Krishna Institute of Pharmacy, Karad, once again welcome you all to this my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to study about the various classification of different analytical methods. In previous video, we have seen introductory part related to the chemical analysis as well as the chemistry subject. If you have not watched my previous video, then you can watch my previous video. And if you like the content of this channel, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel to get the more videos related to this pharmaceutical analysis subject. Now, before starting our today's presentation, just we will see what are the learning outcomes of this session. After watching this video, students will be able to explain different types of analysis and different analytical methods. Analytical methods are nothing but these are the part of the chemical analysis. These are nothing but the different techniques that are used to carry out the analysis of different substances. Just like in cricket, if you are using different type of shots to play the ball, similarly here in this analytical chemistry, we will be using different techniques to carry out the analysis of that particular substance. Now, first we will see what is the meaning of analysis. As in first video also I have explained what is the meaning of analysis. Here, in this case, we will be observing, if we want to carry out the analysis of a person, we will be analyzing him on the basis of his dressing, his attitude. So similarly, in pharmaceutical analysis, we are going to carry out the analysis of that particular substance depending upon its chemical composition. Just we are going to observe something in the analysis, and it will depend upon the what type of analysis we are going to perform. Now, basically in pharmaceutical analysis, analysis is divided into the broadly two types. One is the qualitative analysis and other one is the quantitative analysis. Now, we will see what is the meaning of qualitative analysis. Here, it gives us information about the identity of atomic and molecular species. Means, which components are present in our substance. That is only information that is provided by qualitative analysis, or the different functional groups that are present in the samples. Now, this qualitative analysis is used to determine the presence or the absence of the compound. Means, suppose four different substances are present, A, B, C, D. In qualitative analysis, we will be checking whether A is present or not, whether B is present or not. Just we will be checking a particular substance is present in our sample or not. That is nothing but the qualitative analysis. In quantitative analysis, it establishes the relative amount of one or more species, that is the analyte or the sample, in the numerical terms. It measures the concentration or the amount of each substance in a sample. So, in quantitative analysis, we will be measuring the quantity. And in qualitative analysis, we will be checking the quality. So, just I will give you one very good example. Now, as you have come to the first year B pharmacy, definitely your class will be having the boys as well as the girls. If I say first year B pharmacy is consisting of both male students as well as the female students, this is nothing but the qualitative analysis. Here, I will be just carrying out or determining the whatever the students that are present, just information related to their identity. That is the male student as well as the female student. So, this is the identity of identity of that particular person. That is nothing but the qualitative analysis. And in quantitative analysis, suppose if I will say first year B pharmacy class is consisting of 10 boys and 10 girls. Here, remember, I will be specifying how many number of students or male students or the female students are present. This is nothing but the quantity. That's why here I have written that it measures the concentration or the amount of each substance. So here substance is nothing but the male student and female student. So here we will be measuring the amount of each substance. That's why it is known as the quantitative analysis. While in qualitative analysis, here we will be determining only presence or absence of the substance. Means male students are present or absent. Female students are present or absent. This is nothing but the qualitative analysis. So this is the very simple example which will differentiate between the qualitative analysis as well as the quantitative analysis. Now, after analysis, so these are the two main types of the analysis. Remember, throughout your career, you will be coming across these two terms daily, qualitative analysis as well as the quantitative analysis. Remember, in quantitative analysis, we will be measuring quantity, and in qualitative analysis, we will be measuring quality. Qualitative and quantitative analysis are carried out for one or more analytes using specified technique or the analytical method. So both the analysis are carried out for one or more substance using different techniques. Now we will see various types of analytical methods. Various methods of analysis can be broadly classified into two categories. So there are two different types of analytical methods are there. One is the classical method and other one is the instrumental methods. Our syllabus is mainly focusing on the classical methods, means 80% of classical methods and 20% is only part of the instrumental methods. Rest of the instrumental methods we will be studying in the your forthcoming years. So basically two types, just you can remember, one is the classical method and other one is the instrumental method. Now first we will see what is the meaning of classical methods. These are based on the traditional method of analysis and may be divided as qualitative and the quantitative. Similarly, chemical as like the analytical methods, classical methods are also of two types. One is the qualitative and other one is the quantitative. Actually, in classical methods, we will be using traditional method. You have also used this particular methods. In 12th practical also, you have carried out the different titration procedures. The titration of the hydrochloric acid with the sodium hydroxide. This is the example of the classical method, which is the quantitative method. Now, in qualitative classical methods, we are going to use, they are used for the identification of color, odor, boiling point, as well as the melting point and the limit test. So these are the various qualitative methods which are based upon the principle of the classical methods. And in quantitative, use of determination of mass, that is the weight of that sample or the volume, that is nothing but the volumetric method and the gravimetric analysis. Already I have introduced you regarding the volumetric methods. This is the prominent example of classical method. So majorly our syllabus is focusing on the volumetric analysis, its types and the gravimetric analysis. So these are the two classical methods in terms of the quantitative study that we are going to study in this particular subject. Now first we will see volumetric analysis. In volumetric analysis, we are going to determine the exact volume of the solution of known concentration which is required to react completely with the solution of the substance to be analyzed. Now in volumetric analysis, just what we have done, we have taken certain substance in the conical flask which concentration is not known, and by knowing the volume of the substance that is present in the our burette, we are going to determine the quantity of or the concentration of substance that is present in the our conical flask. This is nothing but the volumetric analysis. So volumetric analysis is divided into five types. As already we have discussed, just we will revise again. Neutralization acid base titration, as it involves the neutralization reaction of acid as well as the base in presence of water as a solvent. Then non-aqueous acid base titration, as it involves the reaction between the acid and base in presence of non-aqueous solvent. So here water is used, here water is not used, means in absence of water, that is the in presence of non-aqueous solvents, that is the organic solvents like benzene, acetic acid, these are the non-aqueous solvents. Then complexometric titration, it is a complex formation reaction. So as these two titrations are based upon the neutralization reaction, these titrations are based upon the complex reaction. In this titration, the reacting substance reacts with the standard solution to form a soluble but very slightly dissociated complex. So, due to the formation of this complex, by using the different indicators, we can identify whether the reaction is complete or not. Such a types of the analysis are known as the complexometric titration. Generally, they are used for the determination of the metallic substances. Then, fourth type of volumetric analysis is precipitation titration. It is which is based upon the precipitate formation reaction. In this titration, reacting substance means that is present in the conical flask, which will react with the standard solution to form a precipitate, which is a slightly soluble salt. And depending upon the formation of the precipitate, we can identify whether the reaction is complete or not. And the last type of volumetric analysis is where we are going to use the oxidation reduction reaction. So this is based upon, or these titrations are based upon the simultaneous oxidation reduction reaction, which are also known as the redox reaction. It includes all the methods where one reacting substance is oxidized while other gets the reduced. So these are the various types of volumetric analysis are present. Then next type of classical method is gravimetric analysis, which is based upon the measurement of weight of substance. So in gravimetric analysis, it is again a quantitative determination of the analyte. Analyte means the sample that we are going to determine based on the mass of solid by the process of isolating definite compound of element in the pure form. In this technique, substance under determination is converted into an insoluble precipitate, which is collected and weighed. Means our analyte is present in the solubilized form. We will be adding certain standard reagents. Due to addition of certain standard reagents, our analyte will react with our standard solution, and which will form insoluble precipitate. And from this insoluble precipitate, we will collect this and which can be weighed. So in this way, gravimetric analysis can be performed. So this is about the classical methods. Next type of method that we are going to study is instrumental methods. Nowadays, these methods are very superior to the classical methods. These methods are based upon the measurement of some physical as well as the chemical properties, such as conductivity, electrode potential, then light absorption or the emission, as well as the mass to charge ratio and the fluorescent substance. These different properties that are possessed by the analyte or the sample are measured in these particular instrumental methods. When non-instrumental method is not possible, instrumental method is the only answer to that particular problem. Means if we can't perform the classical methods, then we have to shift towards the instrumental methods. Actually, the instrumental methods have certain advantages of being less time consuming over the classical methods. Various factors such as cost of instrument, sensitivity, accuracy, precision and reproducibility of the results have to be taken into consideration. For just instance, just you can remember that instrumental methods are more superior towards the classical methods because they require less time. Just we have to design a suitable instrument which will give us a highly accurate results. Then again, we can use instrumental methods for qualitative as well as the quantitative. In qualitative instrumental methods, we can use chromatography, electrophoresis, and this identification by measuring the physical property like spectroscopy as well as the electrode potential. Then in terms of quantitative, we can use the different spectrophotometry as well as the mass spectrometry as a technique. In the detail, we will study these techniques afterwards. Then we will see what are the advantages of instrumental methods. Small amount of sample is required for the analysis. Determination is very comparatively fast. We will require very less time. Various complex mixtures can be analyzed with high sensitivity as the selectivity. Results obtained by the instrumental methods are reliable and accurate. Now, what are the disadvantages? Instrumental methods are comparatively costly, need of regular maintenance of the instrument, skilled person is required, specialized training is required for handling instrument, and sensitivity as well as the accuracy depends upon the type of the instrument. selectivity instrument is required for the specific samples.